All right, let's bring in House Minority Leader, who is almost Majority Leader, and Speaker Kevin McCarthy. Congressman, it was a very close vote. You deserve a lot of credit for the fact that Republicans are now in striking distance in the House. Not one expert predicted this. People have been focusing on the presidency, not enough of this unbelievable news that came out for Republicans in the House. Do you believe that Nancy Pelosi realizes she's going to have to actually do deals with you to get anything done?
I don't think that's in her nature to ever want to work with Republicans. We've seen it time and again. But if you watch what's going to happen on the floor today, they're going to change the rules. And they're changing the rules only to cheat the minority. And they're not just changing a rule that's been around for a little while. It's been in for the history of the entire Congress. The minority has always had the ability to offer an amendment on a bill. They are taking that away. They're trying to silence our vote. They're trying to silence our speech. In essence, our constituents. And watch what she did yesterday. Such a razor thin to even win the speakership. She brought a member back that who has not been to Congress since May and had COVID starting on December 28th and was not and did not test negative before she allowed that person to come back. That is how fearful she is of losing this majority and changing the rules on this floor.
How is that allowed?
They have the votes. That's the unfortunate part. And think about it. For every single Democrat that voted for Nancy Pelosi, they voted to put a person back on the Intel Committee, Swalwell, who has been with the Chinese, only because she could not remove that person because she needed his vote for Speaker.
That says a lot. Let's talk a little bit about this. There was a recording like people have never heard before where the President of the United States is on the phone talking to the Georgia Secretary of State and his general counsel. Mark Meadows was there in the Oval Office and things like that. It sounds like the president is telling Brett Raffensperger, hey, you got to find about 12,000 votes because this was stolen from me. They're there somewhere. How do you interpret what you heard and what you read about what the president and the Georgia Secretary of State were talking about?
Well, what I read about, the president has always been concerned about the integrity of the election. And the president believes that there are things that happened in Georgia and he wants to see the accountability for it. But does anybody in America think the last election was done well? I'm still waiting on a race in New York that has not been declared yet.
You got two races.
What has happened here in this last election, because of COVID, people just sending ballots out to anyone who's on the rolls. Well, these rolls have not been cleaned up. And this isn't the first time this has happened. When are we going to straighten out our elections? And when can we have a debate about the integrity of the elections? And if we really want to unite this nation, that's what the House should be doing in the Senate. This should never happen again in the future. We've watched it before. We have to change it. And we have to make sure that our elections are accountable, have integrity, and are safe.
Yeah, I watched you last night when you gave that beautiful speech, and you were talking about your dad being a firefighter, and you said, I will never defund the police. You know, that message, they stopped using that message after they realized it wasn't polling well with Democrats. What's going on in the state of Georgia? Do you think they'll flip-flop on that if they win, these Democrats?
Oh, they're going to flip-flop on it. They can't say amen to a prayer. You cannot say you're a father, a son, a mother, or a daughter. You cheat the minority on what's the vote on the floor. They're not coming closer to what the American people want. They're going further away to protect their extreme radical views. The only thing in the Democratic Party that grew was the squad. You know, not one Republican lost in the last election. And what their whole mantra, the last Congress was the least productive Congress in 50 years. Did they change the course to make it more open for more voices to be heard? So you have more input? They reelected a speaker who went the entire summer, who said it's better to do nothing on COVID than to do something, and they want to accuse the Republicans are not acting? They want to defund the police. While our streets were burning, they chanted. They didn't do anything to help this nation. That is why they lost at the polls. That is why they not will be the party of the future. And that is why the Republicans are going to hold to our commitment to America, to rebuild this nation, to restore the integrity.
And of course, even in, you talk about our streets being safe, in Portland, 200 plus days of protests, the left-wing mayor finally says, I've had it with Antifa, I've tried to reason with you, now we're gonna crack down. Good luck, half your cops quit. That is the blueprint that these Democratic candidates want the rest of the country to have, which is just astounding to me. This hasn't been said more by Loeffler and Perdue. Let's see if the president brings it up tonight. I have a hunch he will. Kevin McCarthy, not enough people give you credit for what happened in the House. You had less money, less publicity, but produced a phenomenal result and not one seat lost. Thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you very much.